Hey everybody, it's Jason Blaha here, and I had a subscriber ask a question, which I'll flip in here, and it's really kind of funny because he said he heard a so-called coach claim that carbohydrates are not necessary because they're not essential, that all that matters is protein and fat, and your body can become fat adapted, and you'll be just fine on nothing but protein and fat. All right, so let me put on my plus five hat of weaponsmithing and let's talk about this for a little bit because there's a lot of misunderstandings here. All right, first of all, when people say carbohydrates are not essential, they do mean dietary carbohydrates. They do not mean carbohydrates inside your body because you will only live a few seconds without carbohydrates inside your bloodstream. You won't live long. You'll usually be unconscious within 10 seconds. So that's how essential they are to survival. What they mean is that your body can make glucose, enough glucose to survive out of both proteins and fat if you need to. Now, a lot of people are not aware of that fact. They're not aware that you can turn up to 42% of the protein you eat into glucose, that your liver will handle that for you. And in fact, for most people who work out, they eat so much protein anyways that probably 30 to 40% of the protein they're eating gets turned into glucose anyways. A lot of people who work out actually end up eating too much protein and not enough carbohydrates, so their body just ends up making carbohydrates, so they have something to fuel their body on, because glucose is your body's preferred fuel source. It's going to use it as a top priority. Now, same thing with fats. You can turn a very small amount of the dietary fat that you eat into carbohydrates. There's a glycerol backing on it. And that accounts for about 1 calorie out of the 9 calories in a gram of fat. That glycerol backing can be turned into glucose. So something like what, around 10 to 12% of the fat you eat can be turned into glucose. Again, that's okay. A lot of people aren't aware of that fact, but that is the case. Now, what he means by essential, actually most protein and most fats you eat are not essential either from a dietary perspective. What people need to understand, essential doesn't mean that your body doesn't need it to survive. It means that your body can't make it on its own out of nothing or out of other products, meaning you can turn glucose, you can turn other things into glucose, right? So therefore it's not essential, but you have to have something to turn it into. As far as the fats you eat, the majority of the fats that most people eat are not essential. Your essential fatty acids are going to be omega-3 and omega-6, also called N3 and N6. Those your body cannot create on its own. All the other types of fats, your body can actually make them out of other types of lipids and even out of carbohydrates if it needs to. Just those two, it doesn't have the ability to do so. Plants tend to make them very, very easily. And most animals are getting enough from their plants. That's why cows and everything have them. They're eating large amounts of grass. They're okay. For humans, we need to consume those things in some form. But you need to understand that for most people, those make up a very small amount of the fat that you need to eat. We're talking about literally something like you need something in the range of 15 to 18 grams of those every day. Total out of all your essential fatty acids, that's not a lot. That's to maintain health and life in the long term. So you're talking about essentially around 120, 130 calories, 150 at the most is your essential fats. Protein, you have essential amino acids. Protein itself is not essential. Your body can make all the proteins that it needs. In fact, the protein that you eat doesn't stay as protein. Your body breaks it down into its constituent amino acids and then reforms it into the proteins that your body needs to do everything. So protein doesn't convert directly over. It gets stripped into the 20 amino acids. 8 of those amino acids are essential. What people need to understand is that almost every protein source in the world has all 20 amino acids. Only some stuff like gelatin and things doesn't, that even plants have all 20, just maybe not at the ideal ratios you might want them at. That's why we have like amino acid scoring systems that determine the quality of any given protein content. The other 12 are not essential. Your body can make them out of other proteins. And in some cases, it can combine even carbohydrates back in to make some of them. So you have 8 essential amino acids. So it's not that all proteins and all fats are essential. Most of both are not. Like most amino acids are not essential, and by a massive or far larger margin, most fats are not essential. So this is where there's this confusion. Well, the problem is that these are all basically building blocks. They're not necessarily your body's preferred fuel source. This is why your body can make carbohydrates out of everything. your body has to have carbohydrates because blood sugar is a carbohydrate. It's glucose. You cannot survive without it. You will be dead within seconds. Every organ in your body requires it. Your muscles require it to move. Fat is always a secondary fuel source. And again, your body only stores fat instead of carbs because it's lighter. It's more energy efficient. Carbohydrates attract water. 1 gram of carbohydrates contains around 4 calories approximately. That's not perfect. It's in that ballpark. So that's a fairly heavy unit of storage, and it attracts water. It attracts several grams of water to it. So for the unit of weight, it has very little calories that your body can hold on to in an efficient manner. Fat is an efficient energy storage system because it tends to repel water. Fat doesn't require extra water to maintain its volume or anything, so water doesn't really add weight to it because it doesn't attract it, and it has 9 calories per gram. It's a far more efficient energy storage. That's why your body has fat stores. That's why animals have fat stores. It is one of the most efficient ways to store energy per unit of weight because you got to carry that weight around. So that's the reason we tend to store it as store body fat, because you just can't hold on to as much of it as you can carbohydrates. But your body prefers carbohydrates. In fact, your primary training fuel is carbohydrates. So the problem you run into is that both from a performance perspective and an anabolic perspective, this is what people are talking about. Yes, you can absolutely survive on a diet with zero dietary carbohydrates. It is, however, not going to be ideal for performance. It is not going to be ideal for muscle growth. Because your body will struggle to maintain enough muscle glycogen on a purely getting all of its stuff without carbohydrates, meaning the glucose that your body creates from protein and fats is very inefficient for muscle glycogen storage. Your body doesn't store it as easily. It takes more work to get it over there to store it as actual muscle glycogen. It tends to be stored as liver glycogen first. So it's not ideal for replenishing glycogen after training. Your body can do it to some extent, but it's not going to do it as effectively as it will dietary carbohydrates. So you're going to have less training fuel for any sort of intense training, whether it's weightlifting, sprinting, throwing things, anything that requires any sort of strength or power. You know, obviously a 30-mile run doesn't require a lot of strength. That's more endurance. Your body can use a lot more fat for that if it needs to. But explosive power, anything strength-oriented, lifting a weight, a sprint, anything like that, requires glucose as its only real fuel source that's going to burn for that. So from an athletic perspective, this idea isn't ideal. Yeah, you could survive that way, because you're taking in only the essential stuff, but it's, again, not anywhere near ideal for most people for athletic performance. And what you're gonna find when it comes to athletic performance or people carrying a lot of muscle mass, some people have the genetics, the drugs, and the work ethic to become champions on full ketogenic diets. Some people do. However, for every one of them who is successful at doing so, there are 40 or 50 athletes in their exact same sport consuming a high carbohydrate diet who are just as good as them, usually, or really close. Again, you occasionally get someone near the top on a keto diet. Sometimes you do get the top, but they're doing it in spite of it, not because of it. It is one of the most difficult types of diets to follow if you really want to be a truly exceptional athlete. And again, when you have an occasional exception to the rule, it makes it look skewed, but the truth is, it is actually more difficult. And even guys, you take like Jamie Lewis, who pulled it off for powerlifting, you need to keep in mind, Jamie's training methods are far more extreme than those powerlifters. Powerlifting has a limited gene pool available to it to be the best. A lot of Olympic athletes on very high carb diets are stronger pound for pound than the top powerlifters. And Jamie's still carb loaded every single weekend. So he didn't even follow a no carb diet. He's still carb loaded every single weekend for 2 days. Think about that for a minute. He still required an excessive amount of carbohydrates every week. He just loaded them into 2 days and ran keto the other 5. He was successful because of that, and he knows that he can't run a no-carb diet for weeks on end and maintain his strength. He noted that himself. So the problem we run into here with coaches talking about this, we're not talking about surviving. We're talking about being athletic in some way if it's a coach. So that's really a problem, and people need to grasp that difference. The majority of top athletes in the world who work under top dietitians consume very, very high carbohydrate diets. And when I say high carbohydrate diets, we're talking anywhere between 50 and 80% of the calories they consume on a daily basis again, of most elite athletes across all sports. Doesn't matter whether it's an endurance-related sport, a field sport, a power sport, 50 to 80% carbohydrates is the norm. So when you have a coach actually saying that just because these are not carbs are not essential for survival in dietary form, that it's going to be ideal for your athleticism to not consume them, he's completely ignoring what all the world champions do, the vast overwhelming majority of champions do, what is found to be the most successful in a wide variety of sports across the board, of all different disciplines. And that doesn't work in the real world. It's a cute theory when you're talking purely survival, but survival is not the same as being athletic. And it's far from ideal. Again, ketogenic diets work for a lot of people as a weight loss aid. Because something is a fantastic weight loss aid for certain people, depending upon their genetics, doesn't mean that it's the best approach for you for maximum body composition or performance in any way. And so coaches talking about it for athletic people, that just doesn't fly. These people who are successful, who do it, are successful in spite of it usually, not because of it. And that's the point that people need to remember here. Remember, for every one of them who's successful doing it, there's 40 or 50 more who are successful doing the opposite approach. They are the exception to the rule, not the norm. Why make things more complicated than you need to for yourself, or more difficult? All right, guys, but that's really all I have to say on that today. I hope it's been informative, and I will talk to you guys next time.